and they tell me that James Brown is the world's entertainer, and they tell me that he is copied the most in music. Now, James Brown is fine for the world, but not for the church. You don't have to copy that music. You cannot, ladies and gentlemen, take something that originated in hell and try to make God accept it by you just saying, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Light on even giving it a name. It's just an idea that we had to open up our hearts and make music that we felt was as pure and as positive as possible. Programming, like what I talked about, the hi-hats, the 808 that usually hits inside of the lowest chakra. Which is your sex chakra.
Now, Romans 1:3-4 says, concerning his son Jesus Christ our Lord, which was made of the seed of David according to the flesh, and declared to be the Son of God with power, according to the spirit of holiness by the resurrection from the dead. The spirit of holiness. So in my title, there's quite an accusation there, and I'm going to prove it to you from scripture. What is holiness? So holiness is apartness, sacredness, set apartness, holiness of God, places, or things. It is separateness. The Hebrew word kodesh is most commonly translated holy. This word comes from the root word kadash, which means to set apart for a specific purpose. So we're talking about something that is set apart from everything else to do a job. Concerning sacredness, this means it is dedication or to be set apart for the service or worship of a deity. Concerning sanctification, because I'm going to be using all of these words interchangeably, to separate from profane things and dedicate to God, or be dedicated to God. So we have been told in the scripture that we are to be holy like God is holy. We are told in the scripture that we are to be separate from the world, that we are to come out from among them and be ye separate. We are told by Peter that we are a royal nation and a peculiar people. We are set apart for the praises of God. We're set apart to bring glory to God. We are the salt and the light of the world. We are put here to be an example to the world and to be the image of God in the world, because Jesus' physical body is no longer here, but he's given us his spirit, and we are now his hand extended and his body. So we are to be the image of God in the earth.